Yeah, we would like to welcome you to the webinar with the topic Building an Equity Portfolio in Times of Crisis. What we will have now and maybe for the next months, nobody knows exactly how long this will take and how fast the market will recover. If we will go to a recession, but we will give you some ideas, some thoughts, what's important now at the moment, and how you maybe can take advantage of the whole situation. So first of all, our risk advice that investment and trading involve risk, including possible loss of principal and other losses. That's, I think, normally everyone knows. My name is Christian Walter. I'm from TradeVola. We are doing trading for stocks and options. Me personally, I'm also the head of TradeStation support in Germany since 2004. In the last years, we also did the support for English-speaking countries. So maybe you or some other people already spoke to me on the phone or to some of my colleagues. And before I started investing in stocks and options, I also did my diploma in business and mathematics. So let's check what we have for a situation at the moment, the unique opportunities in long term, because as I told you in the beginning, nobody knows really how fast the market can recover and how long it will take that some stocks might be on the same level like in January, where most of S&P 500 stocks, if we look to the US market, been on a nearly all-time high. So it's very important if you decide now to invest for a longer term period that you really need to do a trading plan. And I just want to give you some hints, some advices, what is important for the beginning, because it's just a short term of a period where we can present here at the moment. But we will have this ongoing for the next weeks and months, and also educational stuff, what we can provide you, what I will also show here in the webinar. So if there's like interest from your side to get the deeper in this topic, just send us information and email, and we are happy to share some more ideas and some more content. So for the beginning, I just pointed out four really important topics. It's like we have trading target. You need to set a trading target where you want to check, for example, what percentage you want to reach as a performance percentage. Very important, because I know a lot of you are at the beginning, maybe the first time starting to invest. Money and risk management is really one of the highest priorities here, what you need to focus, and also, of course, strategy. You need to choose products and markets, and also holding period and of your positions. But most of these points, they are like in some way connected to each other, but we will go step by step through all these points, and I will also give you some examples how I want to do it, or how we are planning to do this. As I mentioned in the beginning, we have some more seminars upcoming where we can also go deeper in this topic, and also provide you a lot of material what you can use for your own investment style. Yeah, the trading target, it's important at the end to set smart goals that are specific, which you can measure, and should be also realistic. Just to give you like some idea, when you want to double your investment, for example, just a stupid, simple example. You want to double your investment in 1 year. So if you calculate this and break down through single month, means every month you have to reach up to 6% performances that you can double your investment in 1 year. And this is really what you need to break down to, like, I don't want to say weeks, but specific to every single month, so you can see how far away you are from your target. You will not reach your target, but it's important to have some targets at the beginning. Sometimes you might be better than a target, but it's really important to blend this from the beginning and to make an actual trading plan. And I think one of the most powerful tools, if you want to keep it short and simple, is Excel. I will also give you, as I said in the beginning, some portfolio example, how I will calculate it. And this Excel template you can also use for every account size. So you don't need to create your own file in this case. As I said, money and risk management. Risk is very important to check, like, what will be the maximum drawdown, what you can, I don't want to say happy with, but what will be the drawdown where you have to stop and close, like, the positions, or to reduce maybe the size and the investment, what you already did. So this is something what is also very easy to calculate in Excel, maybe 10, 20% maximum drawdown. If you started with a portfolio of 10,000 euro or USD, you can set up an alert or anything else what gives you a warning when you come close to this number, so that you are not able to risk more than what you calculated in the beginning. It's the same with the target. I think at the end, this is something what I can give you as advice. It's always chance risk related. The higher your risk, normally the higher should be also the chance and maybe the performance. But this is something what is always very close related to each other. So definitely before you start opening positions and creating a portfolio, you have to check your numbers and decide what exactly you want to risk and how much money, for example, you want to put in one position. Because this is the second thing, position size. I will also give you an example for this. As I already told you, I'm provided an Excel file where you can split this. You have to think how many positions you want to open. So if we take, like, simple numbers like $10,000, and you decided you want to invest 10,000, sorry, 10 in 10 different stocks, then you can choose for every stock 1,000 USD. And this is something what you also should keep in an Excel file. But as I said, we will see concrete examples. Just let me finish the other two, three slides. So I will later give you some examples for the US stock market. Here you see an example in TradeStation Securities, TradeStation Global Platform, because this is something where the value and all the tools what you can use in TradeStation, for example, RadarScreen, what's really powerful tool, will help you. And you will see this later also in the Excel file. I split it in two different sectors, like finance, healthcare, retail, communication. I chose different stocks which I might put into my portfolio. And from this, I can easily access, like, all the information, like charts, like order bar, where I can set my stop order, my entry order, my target order, or my trailing stop. This is really simple, and I think especially to create a long-term portfolio, TradeStation especially with the radar screen, will help you. And we will also provide you extra tools for it. Like we have many different tools for radar screen. Like here, you can set an alert for all the different stocks, CFDs, Forex, everything what you include here, what will give you like a message if there's like a price reached, if it's like up or down. You can set the different alerts. What's really simple, you just have to type in the number here. But we will also see this later in TradeStation Global Platform Live. So I can show you this exactly with the example which I provided in an Excel file. So important is to define a strategy. It's like, I don't want to say like you should create an automated strategy. This is something else. What can be maybe in the next step or like in a few months later, if you're able to automate some of this stuff, especially maybe exit with stops and targets, then it will help you to write this down all in the beginning. For example, what I already told you, how many stocks you want to include, which size of your portfolio money you want to invest. Because if we go back to this $10,000 example, I don't want to recommend in the beginning to invest this $10,000 straight away in one day. You can split it in different parts. This is also something related to the risk management. And so you see, strategy, money management, risk management, this all comes together, and this should be all written down in some sort of Excel file, some Word document. There's also freeware on the internet where you can find what might help you as a trading, to keep it as a trading diary, but you have to write it down. This is really important. Also your trading rules, which we already discussed earlier, for example, with the maximum drawdown, how much positions, so you can see this is all related to each other. And you should also, especially as a beginner, check your trading rules in the beginning, if you really followed them for every single trade. And this means for the entry and the exit. So this is really important and should be all prepared before you start trading. Same with the products and markets. As I mentioned in the beginning, we will give you an example for a stock portfolio. We are talking about equities today, but you can do the same, or you should do the same exactly for commodities, for CFDs. If you want to create it for Forex or for futures, it's at the end everywhere the same. I just see at the moment a big potential for the stock market, because yeah, in Forex or futures, there's like not that low prices what we have at the moment in stock market. So you should really choose which products, and for beginners, I really would highly recommend that you start with a single market. I mean, even all the experts I know, and we are really successful in trading, they don't trade futures, Forex, and stocks in the same time. You can do one thing, of course, you can concentrate on stocks, and you can choose it either from London, from the US, or from Germany. This is something what I think is still possible, but normally, when you're really expert in one field, why should you add a second or a third market? So this is also something where you should think about in the beginning. What I can only recommend as an example from my side is that you should look for the liquidity. So when we discuss it about stocks, I mean, other than US stock market, of course, we have a good liquidity in some German stocks, in some, of course, from London. But I would always recommend to trade like the original product. So it means better stay with stocks itself than CFDs, Or if you want to trade CFDs because you have a smaller portfolio or small size portfolio, then really check carefully what are the rates what you have to pay, because with all the products created like from banks, you have to check what are extra costs or hidden costs. And for like stocks or stock options or even futures, it's pretty simple. But when it comes to other warrants or CFDs, you have to be aware that there can be extra charges like interest, etc. So this is something where you also have to investigate in the beginning, or just follow the advice. Try to stay with the original product and trade it direct with one broker who has access to the market. Same like what we have here with TradeStation Global. We are not a market maker. We are not trading against you. You can see like the market depth, all other participants of the market. So this is all something what should be done as a research in the beginning, where you need to check which markets, which is the best commission, which additional software do I need. And I think everyone who's like with us, I think TradeStation Global did this in the past, so that they found out you have really high performance platform which you can use for many different markets here. And this we would also see in the next minutes. Here's an example for like different markets. We also see it not only as a screenshot, you can see it later also in the TradeStation platform live. But for example, we have here London Stock Exchange, different stocks. We have equities from the US, you have Forex. These are all different markets and indices which you can trade as a future or also as an ETF or CFD, of course. And here you can already see how easy it is maybe to work with TradeStation and what's the benefit. You just have to click on one symbol. You will see your market depth. You can place your order here in a matrix with all different types of order settings. And also you can use chart trading to change like levels for your targets, for your stops. So I think in terms of usability, TradeStation, not only for beginners or also for some more advanced trader, can bring you a lot of benefits. The last step is, like we said a few minutes earlier, you can also automate a lot of things. There's an integrated easy language which helps you to produce your own strategies, fully automated strategies. There are also a lot of examples which you can also use to make this maybe a little bit more efficient for your entries and your exit orders. And the last thing is the holding period of positions. How long do you keep positions open, or on which interval you want to trade? This is also something what is related to your time. How many days you want to spend in 1 week in front of your computer? I mean, interval at the end, I will show you some examples. You should also look in maybe shorter intervals, especially now at this moment, because you will see big movements during the day as well. And even you want to invest for a long period of time, you should get this positions as cheap as possible. You will never hit the lowest point, but I always recommend to check in different intervals. And I mean, the holding time of your positions depends at the end also on your stop and on your target and how volatile is your market, is the market. So you can't exactly define how long you want to keep a position, but especially if you want to have like long-term portfolio, you just keep this in mind that you need to check this for stops and targets quite careful, because in this high volatile regime where we are now, it will be difficult to keep it longer if it's too close to your entry price, for example. But this is just like five, six really important topics which you should think about in the beginning, no matter which markets you want to trade, no matter how long you want to be invested in the market. And now we go into a little bit more detailed how I would recommend it, or how I did it and show you some examples. So just a second, we change now and we will go to our TradeStation platform. So here you can see an example. Let me make the radar screen a bit bigger for you. I did a research which sectors are important for me, and then I tried to select from each sector maybe one of the biggest in the market capitalization, or also what was for me really important, especially to prepare or to build a long-term portfolio, to check for dividends, for really high dividend stocks. So you should see the radar screen now. Here you can see, for example, all the symbols, descriptions, or you see the V, for example, is for Visa Incorporation, C for Citigroup, and so on. And when you found all the sectors where you want to invest, what really helps you to find maybe the biggest stock with the market capitalization in a certain way is this website. It's for free, finvis.com. And let's check out on Citigroup. You can see here the chart itself. And that's what I want to or what I explained to you. There's a high dividend at the moment of 5.4%. Of course, because the stock went down a lot, it's almost half of the price what we had in the beginning of February or middle of February. But when you want to build a long-term position portfolio, it's really important to see if there's a dividend. What is the dividend? When is the ex-dividend date? All this information you can find out here in Finvis, or you can also check different of other websites which we are happy to provide you as well. If there's any question, you can also feel free to use the chat function to ask, maybe during the webinar or at the end as well. And if you want to see what are the biggest finance or money center banks, you just click here on this sector, and then you will find it smallest and the biggest, JP Morgan, market capitalization a little bit higher than Bank of America. And now you have a ranking where you can exactly see which are the biggest 3, 4, 5, also from the countries which are listed here in the US stock market. And then you can decide it from dividends, maybe from some news research to find one or the other of one sector. And the same actually we did with all the other sectors as well, which are written down here. Technology, we chose Microsoft, healthcare, Johnson & Johnson, and so on. You can see all the explanation and the description here. And then, as I told you also at the beginning, I wrote down this into an Excel file. I just don't want to go too detailed because we don't have this time. It's just like giving you some ideas, some thoughts. And as I said, we will have a much more detailed seminar for this online seminar also, which will be recorded with a lot of documentation stuff, which also includes a professional trading plan as an Excel file, a little bit similar to what you see here. So for example, here you type on your budget. It's just an example. I put it like 100,000, but you will see as soon as I type in 10,000, it will split the amount for every sector here as well. Because what we did, we said like, we don't want to invest all this 10,000 euros. You can also choose like a different currency. It's also not related to a currency, this Excel file, because we will include a currency exchange rate. It's quite basic, but it will help you at the beginning to really understand what is important for you. So what we'll see, we decided in the first part, we want to only invest like 33% of our whole portfolio, means the total amount of the first investment should be 3,300 euro. And from this 3,300 euro, we split this in our different sectors where we decided to invest. For example, healthcare, we skipped this. In retail, we just decided, for example, for Alibaba and Nike. But you also have to be careful. You have to make a screening as well if the price will match your portfolio. Because now, as I decreased it to 10,000, some stocks like Alibaba might be too expensive. Or you can just buy one stock, but this is, should be the minimum which you will buy here for example. So that's the first step. Whatever is your currency you want to trade in, you can do this in British pound or Swiss franc as well. Then, because we are trading on one of the highest liquid markets, means the US market, I need to include here the exchange rate. We can also double check this quite easily and include it here in our screen. So it's exactly 1.08 and 120. So because this is changing, and if your base currency is euro, you're also related always to the exchange rate. So this should be also included as well. Very important, what we decided also to include in our trading plan in this Excel file as well is the approximately dividends which are paid yearly. So you can see, especially in energy, we have some really high dividends. For example, BP is paying 15% at the moment, but also some airlines are paying more than 5% if you see this with Delta Airline, for example. So this is something what needs to be done in the beginning from your research side, where you should include which sectors you want to trade. You should choose some of these stocks based on some ideas I gave you. You can also not only do it with the market capitalization or dividends, there are much more important facts which you can also double check. And then we have here different ways to invest. Let's make an example. We will check this, for example, for American Airlines. So let's have a look at the chart as well. So we see here American Airlines daily interval where you see it's hitting again the lowest point today. I will make it a little bit bigger so you can see it a bit better. So to get a good entry point placing an order, you have like different options in the beginning. You can say either, okay, if it's going down another 10%, I want to buy this stock here for $9, $8.50. 10% should be $8.50. So the easiest thing is just go to your matrix and place an order as 850. And I just want to give you an idea how you can maybe also earn money for waiting to get a price. So 850. Oh, sorry. But this is the way how it should do, how you should do it. Just place an order in order bar or matrix. And the other thing, what I want to just give you an example, that's also possible to get a cheaper price without just placing a limit order, is where we come to stocks, to options. And if we just say for maybe 40 days, 39 days till the 15th of May, well, let's make it maybe 1 week earlier, the 8th of May. So approximately one, we have here 1 week, 1 month. Let's check if we have somewhere a little bit better prices. Yeah, here. So I hope you can see this. 850. So if I want to buy for $8.50 American airline, I think everyone in the beginning just places a limit order and that's it. But you can also get money out of this, because if I sell and put option, what's called writing and put option, I get at the moment between $125 and $203. So let's say we take the middle and it will be $170. And that's only for, okay, it's for 46 days. But you will even earn money without having maybe this stock position, just with premium. And that's exactly what we did, and what is at the moment, because of the high volatility, it's a really, I don't want to say it's a lifetime chance, because it might come in 10 years again, or it will stay on a high level. But this is something what you should really consider in building a stock portfolio for long term, that you will get a lot of premium if you just don't simply buy and hold these stocks. If you try to do it with some extra investment, and this is how you can do it here with the options. And I just want to show you how we also calculated this in our Excel file, and this will be also one of the upcoming topics for the next few webinars which we present here. So let's go back to our portfolio. If I'm jumping too fast or something is not clear, please be so kind and send me a message in the chat. I'm happy to explain it a little bit deeper to you. Just go back to 100,000, because this was the portfolio which we planned. And here you can see the same sectors which we have on the other Excel file. And we want to buy Visa, we want to buy Microsoft, also Nike, Disney, all these stocks which were listed also on our radar screen. And now every week we wrote put options to get some of the stocks. The only important thing what you have to remember, one put is, or one option is related to 100 shares. So you can also only do it to a little bit bigger portfolio. I think for 10,000, it might be also possible, especially for small stocks like American Airline. But just to give you some ideas, the first few weeks we had like small losses, because we always try to get a lower entry price. But especially in this high volatile period of time, we made on the total investment, remember on the 100,000 euro, we made in 1 week, last week like 3.8%, sorry, last week 1%, 2 weeks ago 3.8%. And this only with our plan to invest 33% in the first step. So the performance is calculated on the whole portfolio, but the investment plan for the first step was only 33. And I think these numbers, also if you see the realized performance for the first 4 weeks where we did this now, it's already 3%. I think nowadays it's hard to get this on any bank, on any currency for the whole year. And also the open premium, what comes in the next few weeks, is another 4%, which means already a total income of 7% to create a stock portfolio. And this is nothing, we didn't sell any stock. We just tried to get like these shares on a lower entry price, which we saved our limit or entry price about a stock option. And these tools are so powerful in this situation that I really suggest to go a little bit deeper in this topic in the next few webinars, because it's full of chances, not only for getting a stock quite cheap, also to get like an ongoing premium for every week. Because if I haven't the stock in my portfolio, it's always also quite easy to get another premium on existing shares and existing stocks in my portfolio as well. But this is some part how you can do it with options. What is a little bit more advanced or needs, especially for the beginning, some training, some seminar as well. If you just want to do it in the smaller portfolio with some small amount, I would highly recommend, it doesn't matter if it's $1,000, $2,000, $3,000, to split it to see exactly what you can buy, how many shares, for example, you can buy. And it's quite simple because it's TradeStation works in the same way like an Excel file. I mean, you can just, if you see here the latest price, I can just copy and paste it. I can include it in my Excel file. So I have the latest price here, and now I can calculate, if we go back to my 10,000, oh sorry, this was 1,000, let's make it 10,000, quite simple. I have here the amount of money which should be invested per position. So if I just take this, and this is how easy it will work with a radar screen in Excel to make calculations. You can also do it in all in the radar screen with the programming language. This is not a big deal. Just let me do this till. So there you can see, for example, I will just change the format, because you can also in some brokers do the fractional trading, but here for example I just want to check this. So you see, for Visa you can buy one share for getting an investment of $200, Citigroup 5, and so on, everywhere where you can see a zero. This was not included in our calculation. Verizon 7 shares, Disney 68, all based on the amount you want to invest per position, and a little bit more advanced Excel file we'll present and include in our next ongoing education regarding how to create a portfolio. Where we will follow this step by step. Here it was just to give you some brief examples, also some more easy language and indicators which you can really use for every portfolio which you want to create, either in TradeStation or in the TWS, because yeah, at the end we are here to help you to get started. And still getting back to this topic, that's sort of a lifetime chance at the moment. I think it's really important to start this as professional as possible. And as you have a very professional platform for this with good access to the market, the next step is to create really a really professional trading plan, including to what we discussed here in our webinar. So, and the last things what I want to follow up with you is the upcoming events as well. After Easter, we have start ETF trading as an European Union citizens, because as you all might know, US ETFs are not able to trade as a European Union citizen. So there's a lot of ETFs outside the US which you can still trade, and even for US ETFs there's some possibilities where you can also trade them. And of course the same what we discussed here for like separate and single stocks, you can also do an ETF. You just have to check really careful what is the price structure. What are the costs? Are these ETFs also paying dividends? So it's the same with what I said at the beginning. I prefer to trade like the original product instead of trading one ETF, because you're always related to the one who calculated the ETF. They can maybe easier going bankrupt than stock as well. So it's possible in both ways. And ETFs, it's like a managed fund at the end. So if there's one stock which is included in the ETF going bankrupt or going to zero, it doesn't matter for the ETF. So they're both ways possible. We can do exactly the same portfolio, the same Excel sheet for ETFs as we did it now for some single stocks. And on the 21st of April, we will have here trading setups for volatile financial products. And this is exactly what I tried to give you with really small details regarding the options. Options is a big benefit at the moment. It's really a chance, which I hope you saw in the performance numbers at the moment, for what you can do to create a portfolio or just trading options as they are. So here we want to give you a deeper overview, what is possible, what you might focus at the beginning, and how to get started. At the end is like you need a plan to get started, and this is exactly which we will show you here. And the last webinar for April so far, May of course there are coming more dates, will be cash versus margin account, what's like advantages and disadvantages. You will also see every of this webinar in our YouTube channel as a recording, so feel free to ask for more content or for other topics which you would like to see in the next few months. That's it for the moment. Thank you for your attention. If there's anything you need to know, you will find here my phone number, my email, and of course you will find most of the content, most of the information on our website.